Hey everyone, welcome back to another PC port review. Today, we're looking at Chorus. Now, just so you know, the key for this game was provided to me by Koch Media, so I just want to make that just apparent before we continue with the video. The developer for Chorus is Deep Silver Fish Labs, the publisher is Deep Silver. The description reads, "Take control of Nara on a quest to destroy the dark cult that created her. Unlock devastating weapons and mind-bending abilities in an evolution of the space combat shooter. Along with Forsaken, her sentient starfighter, explore ancient temples, engage in zero-G combat, and venture beyond waking reality." Chorus is on sale for $39.99. It is single-player and has full controller support, Steam achievements, but no cloud saves. Now, from what I'm seeing here and what I've experienced as well, there is ultra widescreen support, by the way. It does not have a field of view slider. It does have windowed, borderless full screen windowed mode, and also VSync. But there are some other things as well to take a look at. With every PC port review, however, one good thing that we've noticed so far is GPU usage is very good. Also, we're looking at CPU usage being somewhat even, but CPU 6 and 8 and 10 are a little bit low across the board. We are getting a very incredibly stable frame time at 7 milliseconds and a fantastic locked FPS at 141 with G-Sync enabled. With that, let's check out the settings menu, just like we do with every PC port review. I'll take off Riva Tuner for now. Now, what we already start with is just a couple of things right off the bat. Now, there is basic information here of controller options. So dead zones for controllers if you want to use those, aim sensitivity if you want to use that, aim sensitivity for the mouse, which I think is incredibly important because I'm using mouse and keyboard for this game specifically. It gives me a little bit of a descent slash wing commander vibe, so I'm kind of doing it, which is pretty nice. Free roam radius as well as aim acceleration. Now this is default to on. If you're going to be using mouse and keyboard, my suggestion is default this to off. Don't even enable it because you sort of like swing your mouse all over the place. And although it's great for, I would say, specific scenarios, it's too wild and unruly for aim acceleration, so I don't really suggest it. I will say, however, though, these small captions on the bottom here, that's really good to see when you're trying to figure out how the game will actually play. So just the radius in which you can freely move the mouse without moving the ship. Pretty nice, right? You now have some sort of description here on what is actually happening when you select and when you change anything here or your settings. Very cool. Controls. You can also change your input device, controller, mouse and keyboard. Now, immediately something strange is showing up here. The nice thing is you see all of the actual keybinds that are here on the right-hand side, but you're not able to actually make a change unless you go down here to customize controls, and then you can make full keybinds if you'd like to. Not only for keyboard and mouse, but also for controller if you'd like to do that as well. It's a little bit of a gripe, but nothing too crazy. I wonder if you can rebind. Yes, you can rebind mouse button. So if you'd like to use mouse button, you can. So mouse 4, mouse 5, etc. That's available for you to use, which is really nice. You can then choose between the two ship types, either capital ships or regular ships, and also custom in two different schemes. But personally, I like the fact that you can actually go ahead and customize the whole thing because that's always nice. Swap boost and drift if you'd like to do that too, and then invert the X or Y axes. Nothing too shabby. Now, display settings. We are playing at windowed full screen. There's also windowed. There is no dedicated full screen option. Would like to see that. That's something we definitely need in every game still, to this day. I don't understand why we don't have a dedicated full screen option. But we're playing at 1440p, VSync is off, and of course max FPS is 144. I have a 144Hz monitor. Now comes the visuals. As with every PC port review, I want to point this out specifically. We have some options available to us. They are very minimal compared to what we normally get for visual options, but we have all this wonderful real estate on the right hand side that is being neglected, where we could easily see what changes are being made in-game visually. Resident Evil 2 has done that very well, Guardians of the Galaxy did that really well, we still are not seeing it being used across the board. It should be standard for this kind of thing because of the fact that we are making actual distance quality changes, anti-aliasing changes, post-processing changes. All those things are very important in terms of what we're doing. The game is very well optimized on a GPU sense, somewhat on a CPU sense, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't have the ability to take a look and see what actual changes are being made. So it's important, I think, that we go through and make sure that we have a visual cue of what is happening, especially with all this real estate that we have here. However, the options, though, are very minimal, right? We have a preset, view distance, anti-aliasing, post-processing, shadow quality, texture quality, effects quality, resolution scaling, DLSS. It's nice that DLSS is there, but the game does a very good job of just running quite well, so I was pretty happy with that. I do like the fact that there is a small description on the bottom side. We can see that as well here too. So shadow quality, pretty much stuff that's just basic, right? Let's move to audio. So we've got master volume, music volume, voice volume, speaker. We're using TV or home theater. Would be nice to have a headphone option, just saying, with a dynamic range as well. Accessibility options, English, different language settings, display subtitles, small subtitles, medium and large, very nice. Display target markers, yes, interface post-processing. And the interface includes chromatic aberration glitching. We're going to just turn that right off. We always turn off chromatic aberration and anything like that. I would have liked the option to turn those off in the game because of just the how they look. So, you know, film grain, chromatic aberration, all those things. They don't need to be there, right? So, options menu is pretty scarce, but not horrible. So they could have done a lot better job on that specifically, especially with what we talked about before. Just visually and having more options available to the player. With that, let's turn back Riva Tuner. We're looking at about 9 gigs of RAM being used and about 4 gigs of VRAM being used, maybe 5 on my GPU. So, like I said, some CPU threads and cores seem to be underutilized while others are overutilized, but either way, we're still not hitting 100% GPU usage, even at 1440p on high, which I think is very cool. But let's go ahead and continue and see how it looks in game. I think visually, this game is very striking. So it's got almost this like really pretty sort of view around it. So if you wanted to go ahead and like do stuff into space, this is one of those games, right? So like Descent, No Man's Sky, etc. It doesn't look as crisp as those games. But I do think that it does have a very cool visual style. We'll go ahead and just hyper jump, I guess. But I think it's got a very cool style to it, especially visually. In the open world that we have here, we're still sitting at about 140 FPS. Some frame dips here and there, nothing too absurd. But it's looking quite well. And of course, having this be in this area isn't too bad. It looks like the GPU has actually been maxed out at 99%, actually. So much fun to see. Scavenger Nora? I could use some help. Understood. So we're getting about a 1% frame drop on specific areas, especially when we do like the hyperspace jump. That's where the frame rate really takes a dive. Also, it takes a dive when we're recording, not really in the game. I feel safer if someone like you can watch my back and handle things. Sounds like trouble. I'll pay you. Let's go ahead and see what she does. Let's help her. Let's jump into some combat as well. Sandwich outpost. It's not that far. You guys can see what this game actually plays like as well and get some information here. So it looks like this is going to be one of the more interesting areas as the GPU usage does spike up and down quite a little bit. Didn't you work at the Enclave? Yeah, I fixed that ship of yours a few times, but I left after it. Well, I still owe Sav. I've got my own workshop now. Business, I think it looks really cool though. It's got a nice look to it, I will say.
And now you owe I see.
Mm-hmm. Oh, also, yeah, she does whisper to herself. Yeah, just gotta get used to it. Almost like, a few other games that do that. Hellblade, that's it. Hellblade does that as well. But not bad usage at, what, 99%? 95, 93? Uh-oh. Oh.
Nara, can you maybe... Okay.
Settle the debt.
I'll cover your debt.
Fine with me. We'll see you, Azan. You're always welcome to join us for another game.
Mm-mm.
Thanks, Nara. You owe me now.
I know. My cargo's still at the Enclave. It's yours. Follow me.
But yeah, I think one thing this game really does need is a field of view slider. That would be so necessary for this game. Seeing as how you're so close to the ship, and just having that would be ideal for the situation. Because right here, it looks so good. If I could just have this field of view without having to accelerate, would be fantastic. Because this seems like the ideal way, the ideal point of view, actually, to play this game. But I gotta say, at some points, this game does look very cool. Bit of a frame drop there, not too bad though. But GPU usage is fluctuating. I'm wondering if there is a memory leak somewhere.
We made it. Here, it's what you covered, plus my cut from the delivery job.
Thanks.
If I repay Sav, I might get my old job back.
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. Oh. All right, so let's go.
You called it my home, Sav. Maybe one day.
Very cool looking city. Let's go check it out, see what happens.
I'm coming in. Your Najuu power cells are all safe.
And your landing bay is ready.
Let's go here.
I'll let
there we go.
The real story.
Very cool.
We've had a lot more refugees lately. Things are shaking up back in cult space.
You're preparing for a cult attack?
Could be nothing. Keep this between us.
So yeah, we're seeing that GPU spike really just show up and down quite often. But yeah, this isn't a bad port. I think there's just some inconsistencies with either driver issues or memory issues. Seems like a small memory leak that's happening because RAM has now jumped up to 10 gigs. But the game does quite well, especially with DLSS and being able to lock the frame rate. So we could chalk it up to OBS, but we can also probably see that even without OBS, these things would still be happening in game. So I definitely recommend having a pretty good GPU. I think borderless full screen mode is not the way to do this game. We should have dedicated full screen. Field of view slider would have been even better or more ideal. And some other small inconsistencies. But yeah, not a bad port. Could have been better. So definitely check it out if you'd like. The link to the game is in the description down below. And thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to see more, check out the channel. Subscribe to it as well. You can also join the Discord. The link to that is in the description down below. And my Twitch and Twitter, which is at, oh no, it's Alex. Hope you guys have a great one. And I'll see you guys next time.